measures of central tendency and variability of grouped data. Let's see how do we calculate the mode in grouped data. When we need to calculate the mode in the case of grouped frequency distribution, we will first identify the model class, the class that has the highest frequency. Then we will use the formula. Mod will equal to L plus FM minus F1 divided FM minus F1 plus FM minus F2 both times H, where L is the lower limit of the model class, FM is the frequency of the model class, F1 frequency of class preceding the model class, F2 frequency of class succeeding the model class, and H width of the model class. We go step by step. Step 1, prepare the frequency distribution table in such a way that its first column consists of the observations and the second column the respective frequency. Step 2, determine the class of maximum frequency by inspection. This class is called the model class. Here you will determine in all classes you have the class that has maximum frequency. Step 3, calculate mode, use the formula. Let's consider an example. Now we have the height of in centimeter of 50 students recorded here. The height in centimeter, you have 5 groups. The first group is 125 to 130, the second 130 to 135, the third 135 to 140, and the 140 to 145. And the last 145 to 150. Number of students in the first class you have 7, in the second class you have 14, in the third class you have 10, next you have 10, and the last have 9. If you see, and if you remember the steps, you have to determine the maximum frequency. The maximum frequency in this distribution is 14. Now, the 14 correspond to the which class? 130 to 135. And this class is the model class of the distribution. Now, let's replace L equal to 130 H, which is width equal to 5. 5 width, this is the difference between the This is the number in the class, in the model class. The model class is 130 to 135, means between there is 5. Fm equal to 14, this is the frequency of model class. F1 is 7, this is the frequency of preceding model class. And the F2, 10, this is the frequency of succeeding model class. Now by a formula, now we replace the formula. We see now have L, this is 130 plus FM, this is 14 minus F1, 7, divided by FM, 14 minus 7 also plus 14 minus 10 times 5. Now the mod will be 133.18. How do we calculate median in group data? To find the median of group data, we have the following formula. This is R plus N over 2 minus F divided by F times H. Here, H is the lower limit of the median class. F frequency of the median class. Upper F, cumulative frequency of the class preceding the median class. N, total number of observations, and the H, width of median class. Okay, let's take an example. The marks obtained in English test by 17 students were recorded. What the median marks of the students? Now have the marks group 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, and have frequencies of each and cumulative frequency. When you say cumulative, you remember that we take the frequency of the frequency and we plus the cumulative frequency of the preceding group. You can see for the first, we have only two frequencies, two, but we arrive here, they have frequency four. We take 4, we plus 2 equal to 6, and we take 5 plus 6 equal to 11. We take 4 plus 11 equal to 15. We take 2 plus 15 equal to 17. Now, we find the value n divided by 2, and then locate the class whose cumulative frequency is greater than the value of n. And 2, and we have 17, and we have 17. Now we take 17, we divide it 2, and we find 8.5. We come here in the cumulative frequency, and we will see from the first. We will see which the number we found, 8.5, is located. Now here 8.5 is located in the group of 20 to 30. Now we have this group. We have frequency of 5 between 6. We have cumulative frequency of second 10 to 20 is 6. Means from the 6 to 11, we can locate 8.5. Yeah, means the 8.5 is located in the class of 20 to 30 max. And this is the class we call the median class. To find the median of a group data, we have to apply the formula. Okay, from the example we have, from the table above, we have L equal to 20, N equal to 70, and F equal to 6, F equal to 5. Okay, now the median will replace 20 plus 70 over 2 minus 6 over 5 times 10, and we'll find 25. The 25 is the median of the group of data. In summary, we can use the following steps to compute the median of grouped data. Step 1, prepare the frequency distribution table in such a way that its first column consists of the observations and the second column the respective frequency. Step 2, the third column consists of the cumulative frequency. Step 3, obtain n and find n over 2. Step 4, find the class whose cumulative frequency is just greater than the value you find when you divide n by 2. This class is known as the median class. To calculate the median, you will apply the formula. Now, how will we find the mean in a grouped data? A mean can be determined for grouped data or data that is placed in intervals. So, unlike listed data in a grouped data, the individual values for grouped data are not available and you are not able to calculate the sum. How to calculate the mean of grouped data? First step is to determine the midpoint, also called a class mark, of each interval or class. This midpoint must then be multiplied by the frequencies of the corresponding classes. The sum of the products divided by the total number of value will be then value of the mean. Here, in other words, the mean of a population can be found by dividing the summation of mf by n, where m is the midpoint of the class and f is the frequency. As a result, the formula mu mean equal to summation of mf by n can be written to summarize the step used to determine the value of the mean for set of grouped data. If the set of data represented a sample instead of a population, the process would remain the same and the formula would be written as x bar, not mu, x bar. The mu is for population, but x bar is this for the sample. Let's take an example. In teen school, there are 25 teachers. Each teacher travels to school every morning in his or her own car. The distribution of the driving time from her to school for the teacher is shown in the table below. And see, this is driving time and the number of teachers. Now, how many groups? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you have number of teachers. So the driving time are given for all 25 teachers. So the data is for a population. Calculate the mean of the driving time. Want to calculate the mean of the driving time of teachers. Step 1, determine the midpoint for each interval. For the interval 1 is 0 to less than 10, the midpoint is 5. Okay. And for second 10 to less than 20, the midpoint is 15. Yeah, this is the midpoint. Now, for the 20 to less than 30, the midpoint is 25. and started to less than 40, the midpoint is 35, 40 to less than 50, the midpoint is 45. You can see. Now I think you understand the midpoint. The step two, we multiply each midpoint by the frequency for the class. Now we multiply the midpoint with the frequency of the class. Remember, the class is having frequency of this number of teacher, 3, 10, 6, 4, and 2. Now, after that, in step 3, we will add all results from the step 2, and we divide by n when we find the mean. So the mean will be 21.8. In summary, we can summarize in a table like that one. You have to write those classes and the number of teacher. This is F, frequency, midpoint of class M, product, this is MF. Then you apply the formula. You will find the mean is a summation of midpoint times the frequency divided by N. Now, when you want to see standard deviation of group A data, we apply this. Here, if you have the mean, we can even have the standard deviation. Those are the formula how we will find out variance and standard deviation.